record videos on the go. Lord, I need lip chap. Let's pause. There, that's better. All right, so I gotta go get my medicine and go start my lift rides for today. So I'm recording. It's the first time for everything, so this look, I don't want y'all to say my word because I need to clean up. All right, Mari. You want me to leave this door open?
Yeah.
All right. I decided to not put no makeup on for today. You know, eyelashes or eyebrows. Just going in my little old natural self. I really need to go clean my car. Okay, like I said, I am on my way to Walmart. I have to go get me some medicine. I got this bad rash on my neck, and I ended up having to go to the hospital to get it looked at and stuff like that, which I knew it was dermatitis, atopic dermatitis, which is like a form of eczema, whatever, but it's caused by inflammation. So I went to the doctor not really knowing, because I was like, what is it, why is it growing like that? But anyways, yeah, I have to get some cortisone, what is it, hydrocortisone cream, and some steroids, some cortical steroids. But yeah, I'm trying to carry this camera for a couple days. I'll see how long I'll do it this week, and then next week I'll do it for another couple of days. There's really no angle with these videos. I'm just recording. I wish I had an angle. So that's something that I definitely have to start getting, is an angle. Let's see if I can come up with an angle now. Got my good old handy dandy water. I keep me a water in the car and a cup. Do lift today. I gotta get a little gas. I had come to this street. I should have went to the other one. This hair, right? I'll talk to y'all about it in a minute. Alright, I'm at Walmart and I'm about to go get my medicine. I was just watching this video about what's going on with Keke Palmer and her baby daddy. Freaking sad. It's crazy. You never know what people are going through. And they look happy. He looked like he was, you know, appreciative of her. And kind of find out, he's saying the most belittling things to her because of his own insecurities. He wants her to feel low because she's capable. And I can totally relate to that. Totally. It's crazy. I want to talk about something that I know a lot of people don't experience. If you're not tall, then you probably have no idea what I'm talking about. But you probably notice it in a very, like, subtle way. But I'm a tall woman with Afro hair. I get a lot of freaking attention. I get a lot of attention. And sometimes, a lot of times, this attention can be very intimidated. People tend to be really intimidated by me because of my height, which is hella frustrating to me. It's so frustrating to me because I am such a gentle giant. And then, you know, when they talk to me, they can tell I'm a gentle giant. But it just, it's so annoying because I'm tall and I get a lot of attention, which I don't really like attention like that. I can deal with a little attention, but I just don't really like attention. And maybe I don't like attention because I get so much attention. But, yeah. Freaking annoying. And then for it to be on the reason of being tall makes it a little bit more annoying because it's like I can't. Wow, I forgot what I'm saying because that person was about to hit me. Anyways, it's a little bit more annoying because it has this negative connotation, or comes with something negative like intimidation. So I have to try to make sure that I'm not being intimidating. It's annoying. But here I am, gonna be this tall girl carrying this camera. I'm about to do it. I'm about to do it in a big way too. So yeah, get ready. Get ready, world. Get ready, because here it comes. Here it comes. Like, I don't know how I want to position my camera. I just took a steroid. It's in my throat. I gotta go get me some gas, and then I'm off to start these rides. I'm going to try to drive late tonight, trying to get these points, and the challenge. I have to do 65 rides in 4 days, and that's not bad. Well, I think it's like more than that for a certain amount of money. But the amount is not bad. So, and then plus I haven't driven a whole lot of hours this week, so I need to recover those hours. 15 hours, so I'd have to drive 20 more to make 40 hours. And I can drive 12 a day. So I'll make it up this weekend. All right, got my first ride. So I'm about to head to the destination, which is 4 minutes away, and we're off. These people is driving crazy. I told y'all it's Thanksgiving holidays. So it's around the Thanksgiving holiday. So people are driving crazy because they are frustrated about the traffic. So, child. So, anyways, yeah, got my first ride. I'm headed to the airport. Like I was saying before, when I get this, when I do these little perks that they give me, one of them is that I can choose to head to a destination. My destination was Dallas-Fort Worth Airport, 26 minutes away. And it'll pick me up some rides along the way to help me get there so that I can make some money, you know, while I'm traveling. And, yeah, that's great because I'll end up at my destination. So that's a cool little perk. And since I only have There's only 5 more hours left in this day. I have 6 perks that I can use in 5 hours. And they can last. One of the perks, like if I want to stay in a certain area, that perk lasts for like 3 hours. So, yeah, I just have a whole lot of perks. And I don't really need them like that because I don't be driving long enough to really use my perks. But at times like this, where I only have 5 hours left in a day, I need to maximize my perks to try to make the most money in the shortest amount of time off of those perks, or to at least try to use all those perks so that, you know, at least I got that boost. But yeah, I'm in Irving. I'm picking up, I think it's a female rider. But yeah, I don't know how to vlog these things. I've had a lot of experiences in my Lyft rides. So I guess I could just vlog the experiences when they're interesting or anything. Because a lot of times people get in and they don't really talk. Then other times they get in and they talk a lot, or it becomes a really great, interesting conversation that we don't, neither one of us want to end. But yeah, that's what I'll do. Cause stuff be happening and I'll be wanting to tell somebody, and I guess I could tell Lyft. That's what we'll do. I mean, I guess I could tell y'all, sorry, in my Lyft. My Lyft box. Oh, wrong street, next street. People are so rude. I'm here. Coincidentally, I just picked up a rider that I had picked up a year ago, and we had talked about like some of the business ventures that I want to do, and you know what I'm trying to do on YouTube, and like who I am in the world and all these different things. And he was like, did you pick me up before? And I was just like, I don't remember. And he was like, yeah, like we talked, and I remember you saying that you wanted to create and you were doing all these things, and I told you that I was new to town and stuff like that. And I was like starting to remember, but I talked to so many people. That's the thing. I talked to so many people that I was just like, okay, dude, what? Because I know I'm open enough. But eventually when we got to the stop, I remembered when I looked at his name. I was like, yo, yeah, I do remember picking up Reza, because I remember thinking, oh, Reza, you know, because it's a rapper named Reza. So I just remember associating that. But yeah, we had another interesting conversation. I be having some really great conversations with people in my lives. And what he was pointing out, which is something I hadn't really paid attention to or even thought about much, was that I'm able to talk to and connect with people of all walks of life. You know, having all kinds of experiences and get words of wisdom from them, or words of encouragement, or things that can be like morale for whatever I want to create with that. Like, because everyone has a different experience, everyone shares a different way, everyone has a uniqueness to contribute, because we really need to be sharing. And by accessing all these different people and getting these different experiences, I'm able to acclimate the things that I learn into my life and my contributions to the world. So yeah, his gem, what I'm getting from Reza, I get that Reza is extremely at peace. Like that Reza understands that things are bigger than him, and he just is allowing in his interactions with other people, he's allowing that interaction to be as unique as it is. He initiates conversation. He carries the conversation. He's interested. He shares. He's really listening, you know. So, yeah, Reza is a great feeling because he's really present with you. He's really present, and I appreciate that about Reza. And, of course, I told Reza my YouTube channel, Simply Sister. So, hopefully, he will see me comment about him. Yeah. So, yeah, that was a really good ride. But this is why I be feeling so good. It's because I be experiencing life in the most positive way, like appreciating the moment, kind of like Reza. Reza is appreciating the moment, and he's able to gain something from the moment. We're able to gain something from any moment as long as we're present and appreciating. So, yeah. Reza, hey! But, yeah, I am at the airport now. So, we will see where our first ride takes us, guys. This airport is busy. Yeah, I'll be back. Really inspired me just now. He really did. Let me see. Lights. But he really inspired me, and it was the statement about that you can't learn from anyone the next steps of your journey. You have to go on the journey. There may be other people doing it. There might be other things that you can learn from on your journey, but you don't get the real learning. You don't really learn it until you do it, because everything that they're trying to explain to you is only explaining a portion of what it takes to do the thing that they're explaining. The other portion comes from experience. So, yeah, I can tell you exactly how I did it. I can tell you exactly what I did. But until you do it, you won't understand. So, I'm having to just do it. And that's the thing. Just do it. Just do it. Yeah, I wasn't ready to just do it. But I'm ready to just do it now. It was a just do it moment. And I'm having a just do it moment. Because I'm filming Lyft right now on my Lyft rides, and I've done this for a few months, but I'm pretty sure that I'm going to be posting this one. Yeah, I finally decided that no matter what, I'm going to vlog, and here I am having some vlogs that to me are going to mean something to me. And that's what I want. That's what I want. I want all my content to mean something to me. And I didn't want to do the content until it did. And here we are. And it do. It means something to me. I'm very inspired and very humbled to have the experiences that I have. And I'm very excited to be able to document them. So, yeah, that. Yeah, I'm at the second, well, this is not the second location. I done been to the airport and everything. I done picked up a few rides since RZA. But, yeah, I love myself and I love my life. Hello, I'm back. Ain't nothing happening tonight. Tonight is really dull. Everybody is dull. So, kind of lame night. But, Yeah, I'm still out here. It is 111. So it's 111. And I am headed back to the airport. I did pretty good with the airport runs. So yeah. I guess I'll talk to y'all later. Hopefully I'll have something to talk about, because it's been dull. Did anything interesting happen? Let me see. You know what? This is a comment that I had. Dallas has some really, snobby people or elitist people. The separatism that I've noticed in Dallas is out of this world crazy. Like, all the Indian people live in certain areas. All the Mexican people live in certain areas. Black, not all, but, you know, big areas populated by, like, one particular group or, yeah, that kind of thing. And then people are so not in touch with the realities outside of their areas or outside of where they grew up in. So the people in Highland Park are not in touch with the way people live that is not as high class as that. Because Highland Park is like, people over there have a lot of money and they just live a certain type of lifestyle. But they are so not in touch with the other people. They don't live, it's like a completely different culture based on the money that they have. Unless you're a cultured person. But I've been noticing that. And then when people get in my lift, they seem really entitled a lot of times. Not every time, because I do enjoy talking to the people that be getting in my lift. But I be having to, you know, play close when it comes to the entitled people, because you are just a rider. You're a rider. You're in my car. You need to respect that someone is giving you a ride. You know, it's the entitlement for me. I've had people say, yeah, can you just pull around here? I'm somewhere else. And I'm like, well, this is the location and your time is running out. They give them 5 minutes. They give you 5 minutes to get to the car, you know? So you call me and you only have 45 seconds left. So what have you been doing for 4 whole minutes? And then you tell me I need to come and find you. Because you don't even know where you are. You're just like, oh, I'm around here, over here, by here. Like, you knew that you called the lift. You knew that the location was where it was. Or you should have known where the location was. But it's constantly that I'm running into people who don't know where they need to be picked up at. Or don't care where they need to be picked up at. They want you to come find them. And I do not respect that. Because you should consider me. You should consider the fact that your driver is coming and your driver may be going to the wrong location. Just let me know where to go beforehand. And if I'm not responding to a text, that's because I'm driving. Call your driver. We don't know. We can't answer a text message. And we don't know where you are. So by the time that we see that you texted us, we're already at the location. So call us if there's a change, if there's something that you need to update or you need us to do something extra or whatever it is, call us so that we can help us help you. You know, don't just feel like you're entitled to ask me to do something extra just because you paid for a ride, because that's not how it happens. I was paid to do what it is that I'm going to do unless you let me know. So, but it'd be funny because these people be really feeling entitled about me as their driver. And it's like, no, it doesn't really work like that. I understand that it probably works like that in other situations, but I'm not her. Yeah, because that be annoying me. That's the one thing why I do not want to continue to do this for too much longer, because I cannot deal with entitled people. I haven't had any real issues or anything, but I have definitely had to, like, you know, have a little, you know, standing my ground with riders in my car. Damn. I missed my turn. This person just really waiting on me. Sorry, y'all. Gotta go. Okay, so I just picked up two girls that were leaving a ball. They were so pretty. But they had, you know, some guys hitting on them and stuff. They're looking to date. They were like 28 and 32 and stuff like that. And they started to kind of talk about their experience and what they're looking for, and the guys that walked them to the car and stuff. And it was real interesting because you have a 28-year-old and a 38-year-old, two sisters who are navigating the dating space as Black women who are successful and looking to date and hopefully date seriously. The 28-year-old is really dating seriously. So the 32-year-old was like trying to, like, give her some advice because maybe she hasn't experienced what the 32-year-old has experienced. So she's trying to protect her sister. And I guess she's kind of overstepping her boundaries as a sister. So, what I was going to say? Damn. So she was overstepping her boundaries as a sister, and the other sister was like saying something about it, and she was just like, nah, girl, because I done been through this and I done did this and woo woo. And so a guy actually had walked her to the car, and she was like, that's what I was talking to him about. I was asking him what's his availability, because, like, I'm just looking for, you know, an experience, you know. So she didn't say that, but anyways, yeah, so she's trying to see how they can just hook that up, because she don't really want to date like that. She's had some experiences that she just doesn't want to experience anymore, so she's not really looking like that. And then plus, she likes somebody. She's in love with someone, and she's trying to fight that because she knows that that's not good for her. But it was just so interesting to hear their stories, because these are other women who are dating. They weren't married. I was married, and I am, like, still going through a divorce. So there's a level of, so I had asked these girls something. I had asked them, do you think that compared to now, that there are a lot, I wasn't really comparing it, but they compared it. But I was like, that there are a lot of dating options for you. And they both said, yeah, but they're not my height. And then they just laughed about that. But then they were like, well, just realistic options for me. Both of them wanted to say no. But the one girl said she had talked to her therapist about it, and she's starting to change her perspective and put herself in different situations so that she can meet a good partner for her, which was really good answer. And because that's definitely how I think about it. And then the other one, she wanted to say yeah too, but she was like, yeah, she just really doesn't date anymore like that. She dates for you know, looking for what she's looking for, because it's so weird that she's gone through so much that she doesn't really, maybe she just doesn't believe that. So, yeah, she's just dating for what she's looking for, which is more of a sexual experience than anything. So I thought that was really interesting. But she had shared with me something that her mom had told her. She said that her mom had said that you know what you want out of a guy after 2 dates. He's only good for 2 dates. If he's good for more than 2 dates, then you'll know it within 2 dates. And I thought that was really interesting that you should be able to pick up on his, how he is, his mannerisms. What are you feeling from him? Are you getting vibes that he could be what you want it to be? What kind of vibes are you getting? But whatever the vibe is, if that's what you're looking for, then you'll know in 2 dates whether this person that you're just going to play around with, or someone that you want to be friends with, or someone that you want to date. But you're going to know that in 2 dates. And I thought that was really interesting, a good thing to consider. So, yeah. Yeah. I've been having some interesting conversations in these calls, in this call. Yeah, anyway, just wanted to show that. Got my weave done. I'm so excited. I'm so happy. I just be coming up with better and better ways to do this hair. I need to get on camera. I really need to get on camera.